Hey guys! Today for the review, I have the WEP 959D2. I received this product from the WEP Tools company to make a review. It's the WEP 959D2 Hot Air Rework Station. Let's unbox it. It comes with a manual and the Hot Air Rework Station. The Hot Air Rework Station is a device that uses hot air to melt and remove old solder from circuit boards. This tool directs a stream of hot air across the device to heat the solder for removal. On the right side is where you put the nozzle holder. Remove the existing screws and then screw the nozzle holder in place. This is the hot air gun. Attach the hot air gun into the receptacle on the front of the station. Put the hot air gun into the hot air gun holder. As noted on top, pull up vertically to replace the hot air nozzle. Otherwise, you may end up damaging the hot air gun. Remove the plastic cover from the display. This station comes with 5 interchangeable nozzles. Store the 4 nozzles in the nozzle holder. Insert the 5th nozzle into the hot air gun. To remove the nozzle, slide the hot air gun into the holder and then pull up. You will need a bit of force to remove the nozzle, so be sure to hold the station firmly with your other hand. As you can see from the 5 nozzles, the amount of hot air differs for each nozzle. Use the nozzle to adjust the amount of hot air blowing on the components you want to remove. On the front of the station, we have various ways to make adjustments. There is the power switch to turn on and off the station. The display shows the temperature of the hot air gun. The temperature switch allows you to toggle between Celsius and Fahrenheit. The fan speed controls how much hot air comes out of the hot air gun. It's time to turn on the rework station. Keep pressing the left arrow to see the lowest temperature it can support. (100°C or 212°F) is the lowest temperature. Keep pressing the right arrow to see the highest temperature it can support. (480°C or 896°F) is the highest temperature. Let's reduce the temperature to 350°C. Once we pick up the hot air gun from the holder, the temperature immediately increases very quickly to 350°C. When we put the hot air gun back to the holder, the temperature goes down very quickly. Let's see how long it takes for the hot air gun to cool down. It took about 90 seconds. Wow, that's very fast. I will remove a component from this PCB or printed circuit board using the hot air rework station. The temperature and fan speed will vary depending on what component you're removing. I will set the station to 350 degrees Celsius, with the fan at maximum speed. Point the hot air gun at it to remove this IC or integrated circuit. Don't leave the hot air gun stationary or you may end up damaging the board. Move the hot air gun in circular motion around the IC. Make sure you use the station in a well-ventilated space to avoid the buildup of solder fumes. I'm smelling the fumes right now. It smells bad. I recommend using this station next to an open window. Use a tweezer to remove the IC. I will remove another IC from a different PCB. This time I will set the station to 400 degrees Celsius, with the fan at maximum speed. Similar to before, move the hot air gun in circular motion around the integrated circuit. This hot air rework station is a good product. As I've demonstrated, it does the job. It heats up very quickly when you pick up the hot air gun and cools down fast when you put the hot air gun back in the holder. It is also reasonably priced. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.